Good day, everyone. This is Sir Rule 196. Hopefully everyone's had a wonderful week so far. Sorry, it's been a couple days since I posted a video, but I've been playing a lot more New World lately, and also getting back into 14, mount farming and such like that, in anticipation of the patch 6.2 release. But we're here to talk about New World, not 14 right now. 14's on to the subject. We just had a new July update pat drop down, which has the musical instruments, supposedly the party finder is what I heard. I haven't played around with it yet. I went in and found that, hey, my bow points respent and everything else. So it's just like, but talking about the bow, I did actually try a different weapon. I did try to do fire staff, and to me, it seemed kind of lackluster. And on an honest opinion, because yeah, you have only three abilities as seen over here that you can actually use, but you have actually a lot more that you can learn and such, but only three abilities at the same time, bound all key bounds. But I don't know if you can actually do that. I haven't played around with it a lot because I just chose the three abilities that I want and I go with it. But yeah, the farming of the weapon grind is, let's say, annoying per se, but it's also nice that you don't have linear specs. If you want to play a tank, you have to do these weapons. If you want to play a healer, you have to have these weapons. And saying about the fifth of the healer, I'm going to get into that here in a moment. But going into and actually going in and say if you want to do DPS, you can have a range, you can do a variety. I mean, you can flip to, with me doing this bow tank, I flip the sword and shield once they get into melee range after I put enough aggro on them, or I put my debuffs from my poison cloud right here up on all the enemies, and then I go into melee range and boom, just start tanking away. Just like that as an example. There's a good example right there. Back there. It's also another thing that I'm starting to do is also starting to get into rep grinds because I want to get a house in the game. Now, the housing in here is instanced, which is really nice. If you want a house, you can have a house. If you don't want a house, you don't have to have a house. And you can have up to three. And I'll show it over here. I mean, right here. But, the only thing I don't like is that not everyone can see your house unless you're the top point holder of that set of houses. Like the one I'm looking at, you need 30 rep grind and everything else before you go and purchase the house, even though there are different tiers. Just like in 14, you have the small, medium, larges. There's like a small, medium, and a large type deal. But going into that, the rep grind is kind of tedious, and especially with I have a quest right up there saying called goats. Do goats exist in the game? Please let me know down in the comments if goats exist in the game, because I cannot find them. I mean, hell, I even had Allah help me out, and she actually went and did this, and poof, there's a goat map right there. There's the goats. You think that with how many turkeys and rabbits and everything else they have, they put more goats, but they don't. They don't. Give me more goats. Instead of these little tiny spots to find the goats. It's just like also the factor of bears. And also about those bears, you want to give them a hug and they want to give you a few scratch marks left and right. And also maul your face in. But that's for a different topic, different story, and so on and so forth. But yeah, I was also farming out corruptions and stuff last night with Allah on stream, and we ran into a couple people, which is fine, and they were just right around our level, except for this one time we ran into people that were level 60 doing them, and these are the level 25 ones, and there's level 45 ones sitting over in Timbuktu that they could possibly do by themselves because no one else is touching them, but they went for these easy ones, and we ended up losing experience and reputation because of that. So what's another thing about the factor of farming and gathering with high levels all around, like the say the starter areas, another con thing that I have about the game is mobs will pull to you regardless of your level. If you're sitting there at level 60 and you're in a 6 area, they'll pull to you. You'll be a 60 and a level 6 mob will come up and pull to you. I literally had a few dozen people come up to me and try and hit me with the mob. A couple of people were successful. Were they successful in getting the ore I was after? Or the item I was after? No. I'm faster clicker. And yeah. So it's just like, that's an annoying little factor. It's like, one thing I would like to see in the game is that if you're at a certain level, they won't pull unless you hit them. That would be nice. That's my little critique per se for this. And going back into the crafting and gathering, once you think you're done with something, you're not. The amount that you need to level up from where I'm at right now, say, and I'm trying to do weaponsmithing and also armoring at the same time, I literally need about still 700 steel to go through, and that's a combination of the sand flux needed, iron ore needed, and that's tedious and everything. I am interested in seeing what the expertise system's like and stuff when the crafters get up there to 200, and also for the gatherers too. That's going to be a long haul still, because yeah, I'm sitting right now currently at 40-41 within the game, and I'm still enjoying my gameplay. But also I'm kind of missing 14, so I've been kind of dabbling over into that and such forth. But with saying going into the factor of MSQ, of rolling into the next thing with the factor of leveling, the MSQ. The MSQ, you only get about one five quest per 5 levels. It's kind of annoying. So it's like you got to fill in the gaps with doing the crafting gathering, doing the side quest, doing the reputation grind to get the extra levels in. Because a la here, we were trying to do MSQ the other night, and literally she was sitting at 21, 22, and her quest was sitting there for 28. Yeah, I'm sitting here at 36, and I was sitting at 36 at that time, but it's just kind of lackluster. Easiest way of putting it, or rather with what comes to mind, is just kind of lackluster, and that she's not really into the story. I'm kind of following it and whatnot, but again, this game is a nice break for me, considering going over what I've been through with 14 and how long, because there's is a lot of content in the game, and this game is still, say, under development, because I've even read some chats left and right about the factor of that the game should be under development for, should have been under development for another year before they went out and released this. But they are throwing in whole entire new systems in here, completely different from any other MMO. And it's working out for them, but it's also kind of drawing back because of the factor of populace sitting there and receiving the game that you don't have to pay a subscription fee for it. You have to pay the $40 for it, one and done, and you have everything. And yeah, they have the cash grab shop because for glamours and whatnot, and I still would love to see some type of, you can transmute a piece of gear into glamour items just to keep that look. Because if you like the armor look, go ahead and put it over there, and you have to cost for a little gold or whatever, that's fine. But using real life money for all the glamour items just kind of bleh. You can't have cool looking armor unless you spend or the way that you want to look. And another thing with the factor of coming into something with release today of the July patch, I want to try to find out with kind of threw me off for a loop here with the game itself is the factor of people selling runs and whatnot with the orbs. Because the orbs had a certain cooldown and everything else to craft them, because I was kind of looking into it. But it's just kind of stupid in my fact. I make money off of people, but it's easy to make money in this game, because I literally went from 2,000 gold to 17,000 just making low-level items. And making money in any type of game, really, unless it's a system that's really, really bent against making gold or gil or whatever the system called, it's just really easy and stupid. So it's just like, why sell out runs when you're making the thing and you're looking for people to help, but you want to sell off your cooldown? But those orbs and stuff have changed. And I think that they put a party finder in here. Finally, with this patch, I'm going to find out once I log in and start playing around with it. Which I logged in for just briefly to collect some rewards, because they even released the musical instruments and sit around in Everfall. Literally had some people playing music, and it's just like, I'm not used to having that because of the factor in 14, I have performance turned off, so I don't hear about the people playing the bard instruments and whatnot. So is there going to be people out there that's going to go on bard hunting? I think I know a few. Just give them a moment. I think I know people that are going to go for bard hunting. But I digress. But it's just going into another thing I'm looking forward to doing, and I'm probably going to wait till I actually do hit 60, is getting into the PvP part. Because I've heard different stories about the PvP, that it's good, that it's bad, that you want dodge roll, and instead of you being, say, a tank with heavy armor, you gotta be a tank with light armor because of the factor of the roll, instead of just the bouncing and sliding left and right, So it's just like, kind of, do I want to do it or I don't want to do it? Because I'm a person that wants to go with heavy armor because of the factor I'm a tank. I'm a tank and I need to tank. I need to be able to take damage, and I don't want to have multiple sets set up for that, unless I am literally changing from tank to healer to that. Which, talking about healing, I said I was going to go earlier in the video, so I was going to get up on the healing. I was going to try out healer and everything, and I even tried it. Well, I didn't really level it much, but you really only have one attack, which is great. It's just a standard, either light or heavy attack. But coming from Warcraft, coming from Final Fantasy XIV, where healers are a big part of the damage, where you have the 6%, you have the 6%, then you have the 6% from the healer and also the tank, but then the rest of it's supposed to be for the DPS. I mean, I like the system that they have, this, that healers are meant to heal, but if you're trying to quest and level up the weapon, you can't do shit unless you're with someone in party. And they have you helping kill stuff, because you can't do it solo. You gotta have a group to go farm elite mobs, dungeons, or whatever to actually level up said weapon, unless you're a damage dealer, which also the damage part, another part where I didn't really get into the factor of doing fire staff, is I hate the factor that you only have 100 MP. And your MP regeneration, yeah, you can pop potion it up, use food buffs, whatnot, to increase it just a little tiny bit. Literally, it's just a little tiny bit. Unless you're chugging, taking shots of mana pots to get your mana back to kill an enemy. Because by the time that you use all your abilities, even though it's only 3 that you get, standard, unless you separate the system to where your standard attacks don't use mana, you're kind of up shit's creek with trying to actually kill something, because you're sitting literally standing there when you're solo, boom, out of mana. Boom, out of mana. Boom, out of mana. I mean, yeah, they have within the Pyromancer builds and stuff I was looking into it, that if you block an attack, you can get some mana back, but it's only like a little minuscule amount. Or if you use a heavy attack. The heavy attack takes the same amount of mana that you get back. So it's just like, really? I'm just like sitting there firing at things that... Also, that's another thing too. There's a lot of things resistant to fire. So, yeah. But I'm going to end it here and everything. Hope everyone has a great day. Like, subscribe, hit me up on the next video. Adios.